Today, we'll solve this binary tree problem on Leetcode in just one line of code. In the process, we'll learn how to solve any binary tree question using two common approaches, top-down approach and a bottom-up approach. At the end of the video, I'll also tell you time and space complexity of our solution. Let's do this. In the given problem, you need to find the maximum depth of a binary tree. Maximum depth is defined as the total number of nodes along the longest path from the root node to a leaf node. If you look at the given example, the longest path on the tree is this path that contains a total of 3 nodes, namely 3, 20, and 7. So in this case, we'll return 3 as the answer. Solving this problem is not that hard, but to solve it in just one line of code, you'll have to declutter your mind and simplify your thinking process. So the goal today is not just to solve this problem, but to learn how to think. We'll achieve this by starting with a top-down approach and then simplify it to reach a bottom-up solution that would be just one return statement. And this return statement would live in this max depth function that takes the root node of a binary tree as input and returns the total number of nodes on the longest path, which is an integer, as the answer. Top-down approach is very simple. In this approach, we start at the root node and go down all the possible paths to a leaf node. As we are traversing a path, we keep track of the current depth. And whenever we reach a leaf node, we compare its depth to the maximum depth of any leaf node that we have seen so far. And if it's more than the max depth seen so far, we update the max depth. In the example, we start with the max depth of 0 and we go to the left of the root node. We reach a leaf node at 9 with a depth of 2. 2 is more than the current max depth of 0, so we update the max depth to 2. After that, we go to this other path and reach a leaf node at 15 with a depth of 3. This depth is more than the current max depth of 2, so we update the max depth to 3. After that, we reach this last leaf node at 7 and the depth here is 3, which is not more than the current max depth of 3. So we don't update the max depth in this case. At the end, we have 3 as our final answer. If you have understood the algorithm, coding it up is very easy. We define a max depth variable that we already discussed. Then, we define a max depth function that traverses all the paths starting at the root node and keeps track of the depth. It checks if the node exists, or in other words, if the node is null or none, depending on the language you are using. And if it is null, we have reached the end and we update the max depth if needed and return. If we have not reached the end, we increase the depth and traverse left and the right subtrees of the node. Now that we have our helper function in place, we just call this max depth top-down function starting at the root node and initial depth of 0. And after this function does its thing, we return the max depth that we found. I hope this was straightforward. Now, someone who writes max depth top-down this way is still a newbie when it comes to programming. Can you see why? The max depth top-down function here is not a pure function because it's changing the max depth that is not contained inside the function. And this is not something an experienced programmer would do. But how do we fix this? We'll have to change our algorithm a little bit. When we reach the end, instead of updating the max depth variable with the depth, we'll just return the depth. Every node now will receive one depth from the left and one depth from the right. The depth returned from the left will be the maximum depth of the left subtree, and the one from the right will be the maximum depth of the right subtree. And each node will just return the maximum of these two max depths. If you want to look at the code, this is how it looks. If you reach the end, return depth. If not, return maximum of left and right. And then we just call this helper function starting at root with initial depth of 0. I hope that you can see that our solution is getting shorter. If you want to write this max depth top-down function in just one line, you can do it by using if-else like this in Python. For Java and C++, you can do it by using ternary operators. So we are at 3 lines now. How do we make it even shorter and simpler? If you look at our first solution, we calculate the depth as we go down and then find the maximum at the leaf nodes. This approach is completely top-down. If you look at the second solution, we still calculate the depth as we go down, but the maximum depth is found as we come back up on the tree. So calculating depth is top-down, but finding the maximum depth is bottom-up in this case. Can we make it completely bottom-up? Can we calculate depth as we come back up on the tree? Before I answer all these questions, we are trying to run this channel without the need of sponsors for as long as possible. So if you want us to continue making videos like this, you can subscribe. Moving on, to make the solution even shorter, simplifying the way we think can help. The way we have been thinking about the solution so far is actually from the perspective of how we will code the solution. As I mentioned in my previous video, sometimes we just need to forget that we know how to code and think from the first principles. So for this question, just think about this. If you know the maximum depth of the left subtree and you know the maximum depth of the right subtree, what would be the maximum depth of the entire tree? It would be the maximum of the two max depths you got from the left and the right subtree plus 1. And when you try to code this solution, it looks like this. If you've reached the end or null, you return 0. Otherwise, you return the max of max depth of the left and right subtree plus 1. Now, You're calculating the depth as well as the maximum depth as you come back up on the tree. And this solution is a true bottom-up approach. Before I tell you the time and space complexity of this solution, if you want to know how to write this solution in one line, here is how it looks in Python and Java. Before we continue, I do want to mention that solving the problem in just one line should never be your main goal. Generally speaking, these one-line solutions usually have some sort of Python coding magic or a recursive solution, both of which can sometimes compromise the readability of the code. So if I was writing the solution of this problem in an actual interview, I would actually go with this more readable version. Now that we have that out of the way, let's discuss the time complexity of the final solution. If you look closely, all we are doing in the solution is to traverse the entire tree. And if there are a total of n nodes in the tree, it will take n steps to traverse all of them. So the time complexity of the solution is order n. Let's discuss a slightly more interesting question about the space complexity of the solution. On the surface, it looks like we are not allocating any extra space to store any data. So the space complexity should be order 1, isn't it? If you think that is correct, then recursion has failed you, my friend. That's because you're forgetting about the space needed for the call stack in this recursive code. For those who don't know, a call stack is what a function uses to track all the function calls. So when you call the max depth function with the root node 3, that call gets put on a stack. And when the root node calls the node with the value 9 to its left, that call gets put on top of the previous call. After this call finishes executing, it gets removed from the stack. And then the root node calls the node to its right, which is 20, and that call is also added to the stack. This keeps going, and the stack reaches the maximum size when the call to the node 15 or 7 is being executed. When talking about the space complexity, we have to account for the space used by this call stack. So if the total number of nodes in the tree is n, what is the maximum size of call stack that you need in the worst case? Well, if all the nodes are arranged to the left like this, or to the right like this, when you reach the leaf node, all the other nodes will also be present on the call stack. That's why the space complexity of this solution is also order n. Today, I showed you how you can learn a lot just by solving one problem, but I did not tell you which exact problems you should focus on and what is the right approach to solve any new problem. If you want to learn that, you can watch this video. My name is Sahil, and I'll see you in the next one.